Okay, I'm sure most of you know whose picture is this. Isaac Newton, right? In 1667, what happened is that Sir Isaac Newton, a young man at that time, he was sitting under an apple tree. An apple fell on his head, and the rest is history. In the next 10 to 12 minutes, I am going to share two of my own aha moments which inspired me on this highly unconventional journey from an engineer and businessman to a marathon coach and marathon and fitness coach. It's kind of thoda sa filmy hai, kyunki films, Bollywood films mein hota hai ki hero jo hai wo ek company mein kaam karta hota hai, uska boss usse kuch daantta hai aur uski garibi ka mazak udata hai. और फिर वो हीरो जो है वो बॉस को कहता है एक दिन मैं इस कंपनी का मालिक बनूंगा. यू नो समथिंग सिमिलर हैपेंड इन 1997 व्हेन आई वाज जस्ट पास्ड आउट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड एमबीए. आई वाज वर्किंग एंड स्टार्टेड वर्किंग. यू नो एट दैट टाइम वाज अ डिफरेंट टाइम 22 इयर्स बैक. Today, there is a lot of awareness about fitness and marathon running. At that time, there was very little awareness about these things. And, getting a paunch and putting on weight after you start working, it was kind of taken for granted time. Now, someone said to me, ki, you two are going to get a paunch one day. And I said, what? What the hell? Then and there I decided that come what may, I am not going to get a paunch in my life. And that, my friends, that is the first of my aha moments. That is the beginning of my journey in fitness and exercise. From that day onwards, I became passionate about fitness, about health. I used to work out regularly. I was watching what I eat. I used to take efforts trying to keep myself fit. I've been taking efforts. I've been running. I've been cycling. I've been trekking regularly. And I've always been into some fitness activities or the other. And now I find that I really enjoy and it gives me happiness whenever I do any activities of fitness to keep myself fit. I watch what I eat and these things give me a lot of happiness. So it's become a passion with me now. My second moment, fast forward 15 years, I had been working in my family business. It was a manufacturing unit, but I wasn't really getting satisfaction out of it. Earning money didn't really excite me. See, nothing against business or nothing against earning money. It was personal. It never excited me. But whenever I used to volunteer for any social activities, for any social cause, I used to find that it gives me a lot of satisfaction. I get a lot of peace, I get a lot of satisfaction out of it. And friends, that is when the next incident happened, and that was my second aha moment. It was the year 2014, and I was running at Mumbai Marathon. After the flag off, I was running, you know, on Mumbai Marathon's route, which is on Worli Sea Face. I was running on Worli Sea Face, and the organizers had put up metal barricades to divide the onward and return lanes. A little far away when I was running, I saw that little far away, about 50 odd meters ahead, one of the barricades had fallen down. And all the runners ahead of me, they were just bypassing and going around the barricade and running ahead. I felt that someone could, you know, fall and hurt themselves on that fallen barricade. So when I reached that spot, I took a halt. I lifted the barricade and put it into place. Now I wasted about 30 seconds or almost a minute in that. But surprisingly, that doing this gave me so much of energy that I finished the marathon in my best time ever. So I realized that was doing something for others, doing something which benefit others, that is what is giving me happiness. And I decided and made it my core purpose, that is to make a positive impact on society. So I had been running for a few years, and I got a lot of immense benefits out of running. Talking about the benefits would take a 2-hour presentation by itself, so I'm not going to go into that. But it gave me a lot of benefits, and I felt that maybe if I could help people to get the same benefits, maybe I could help to make the world a better place. So I combined my passion for health and fitness and with my core purpose, my desire to make a positive impact on society, and I decided to become a marathon and fitness coach. So I did, like the compare mentioned, I did a marathon fitness course. It was a course in Mumbai, it was a 4-month course, and I was the only one among 25 people who used to travel every weekend to Mumbai, attend the course on Saturday and Sunday and come back. And I was surprised to see at the end of the course, after the exams, after the orals, that I had topped the course. I was now an officially certified marathon trainer. I came back, and I'm happy to say that my wife, my friends, my family members, all of them supported me, and I started with training. I became a marathon trainer, and I started training people to become fit, healthy and happy. Active Energy Athletic Club was born in 2015. Active Energy promotes what I call as sustainable fitness. That is, it is possible to become fit without doing anything extreme and without getting into fad diets and such kind of things. The vision of Active Energy is to help people get genuine happiness about doing something good for themselves, and eventually help Nashik to become the fitness capital of the country. I'm happy to say that today more than 75 plus fitness enthusiasts are part of Active Energy. Amongst the top professionals, architects, industrialists, doctors, engineers, CAs are a part of this group. And when a person is happy, not just himself, but by extension, it has a cascading effect on society. When a person is happy, his family is happy, in his organization, his subordinates are happy, his organization is happy, and his society is happy. So you cannot imagine the kind of satisfaction that I get out of this. What have I learned from marathon running? I would like to share a few things which I learned from marathon running. First and foremost, anything that is worth achieving is worth working hard for. There are no shortcuts, and unless you work hard for something, you should not expect miracles. This is something which I've learned from marathon running. Secondly, learn to enjoy and learn to accept the situations and learn not to complain about things. Whatever comes your way, whatever situations come your way, if you complain, you're just wasting time, you're wasting energy, which would have been otherwise useful to face that situation. So in last year, I had traveled to the US and I did a 24-hour trail ultra marathon. It was completely off-road in the forest, and it started at 6 o'clock in the morning, and ended next day morning at 6 o'clock after 24 hours. When the race started, it was cold in the morning. I was running throughout the day. In the afternoon, it became hot. In between, it was raining also, so I was running in the rain. In the late evening, it started become cold. At night, it was dark, and you can imagine when you're running in the forest in the dark, it was completely pitch black. Completely pitch black. You had to run with headlamps on your head. It had suddenly rained. There had been a lot of rain, so the route was quite muddy and chikalasana, so it was quite muddy. So I was running through all that. I could have complained, but then it would have only wasted my time and I would have added to my troubles. So rather I thought, how can I face these things? And thought of solutions on the spot. And happy to say that I finished second in that race. I will tell you a funny incident which happened during that race. Sometime in the afternoon I had been running. Well, in such ultra marathons there are very few participants. It's not like a regular road race where there are 1,000 plus participants. There were only 50 odd participants. I was running, so I was all alone. And it was a trail, so there was just a single lane kind of kacha footpath on which I was running. And all of a sudden, I saw a big snake which was halfway across the track, halfway across the path. So I just halted. It was a biggish kind of snake, so I was thinking whether to jump over it and run or just wait for it. I thought that if supposing something happens, that snake was looking at me, suppose it bites me, the nearest hospital would be not nearer than 50 kilometers away. There's nobody around also, so maybe it might be half an hour before someone finds me. So I thought I'll just hold on for a moment. So seconds were ticking away, but I said, okay, that's okay. And that snake eventually, it went across the path on its own way, and I continued with my run. The third thing which I have learned is that stay humble. Whatever it is that you achieve, there is always somebody who's bigger, who's run better than you, run longer than you, or who can run faster than you. So never ever think that you're the best. There is always much more to achieve, and I'm always in a learning mode. It's just a process. And I come to the last point, is that I found many similarities between life and a marathon. It's not a sprint, it is a long run. So you got to start slow and enjoy the route, enjoy the views, and you don't have to take yourself too seriously. I will tell another short story. I was running Pune Ultra Marathon a few years back. And it was a 100 kilometer ultra happening in the winter. It happens every year. Happens on the outskirts of Pune on a trail route again. The format is 4 rounds, 25 kilometers. So you have to run 4 rounds. So I was standing again with around 50 odd runners. The race was flagged off at 6 o'clock. It was completely dark. When it started, I was the last. Absolutely the last. Everyone had gone ahead. In fact, I was getting worried that if I take a wrong turn somewhere, I might get lost. But eventually, 3 or 4 kilometers, I caught sight of the last of the runners. And I slowly started passing them one by one. After the first round, I was 18th in the ranking. We started on the second round. And after 50 kilometers, I had come up to 8th in the ranking. After the third round, that is after 75 kilometers, I was told that I am first. And after I finished 100 kilometers, and not only finished first, but I set a new course record, which still stands to this day. So it's possible to start last, start slow, and still come out on top later. So a few words to end. Yesterday I was running 75 kilometers and I was thinking about this talk which I'm going to give today. With so many benefits of running, I was thinking, what is the flip side of this? What could be a flip side? And I realized that my wife complained that aapko acche kapde khareedne ki ichha nahi, you don't buy any new clothes. Ab kya karun? Last 23, 24 years, jab main engineering pass hua tha, mera size bhi wohi hai aur wajan bhi wohi hai. So I can't help it, I'm wearing the same size. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.